Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Amma ba'da habita fillah. I wanted to mention, as a reminder for myself and my brothers and sisters, about Tawbah ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, about the repentance and the seeking of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His grace and favor by making Tawbah, by making repentance sincerely to Him and Him alone. And this is an actualization of Tawheed, this worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and making Tawbah to Him alone and for His sake subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abu Barda radiyallahu ta'ala anhu qal, Sami'tu al-Agharra وكان من أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يحدث ابن عمر رضي الله تعالى عنهما قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أيها الناس توبوا إلى الله فإني أتوب إلى الله في يوم 100 مرة أخرجه مسلم. In this hadith, Abu Barda reported, I heard Al-Agharra, who was a companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, telling Ibn Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, O people, repent to Allah. I do repent to Allah 100 times a day. This was the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So reflect upon your own sins, reflect upon your life, and reflect upon making Tawbah to Allah azza wa jal. Al-Hadith ibn Suwaid reported, I went to Abdullah to visit him while he was sick. He related to us two narrations, one from himself and the other from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, saying, Allah is more pleased with the repentance of his slave than a man who encamps at a place where his life is jeopardized. But he has his riding animal carrying his food and water. He then rests his head and sleeps for a short while and wakes to find his riding animal gone. He starts looking for it and suffers from severe heat and thirst, or what Allah wished for him to be to suffer from. He then says, I will go back to my place. He returns and sleeps again. And then while getting up, he raises his head to find his riding animal standing beside him. Allah is more pleased by his slave's repentance than the pleasure of this man on finding his riding animal. And this is in with food. And this is in Bukhari and Muslim. Ahabata fillah, Tawbah ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has conditions. And from those conditions, Imam bin Uthaymeen rahimahullah ta'ala mentions some great benefits. He mentions that there are five conditions. And these five conditions are in fact contained where some of the imams, like Imam An-Nawawi, mentioned three conditions. These conditions are complementary of one another and not contradictory. Imam bin Uthaymeen mentions the five conditions. He says the first is ikhlas lillah. And this is that the slave makes his tawbah sincerely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala out of fear for Allah and out of love for Allah azza wa jal, that he's seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and not to be heard or to become famous with the people for being a person who is pious. The second condition he mentions, an-nadab ala fi'l al-ma'asi, meaning that the person is sorry, they feel sadness for having been done this sinful act. And the third condition he mentions, an yukla'a an them, that the person leaves off the sin that he or she has committed. The next condition the Imam mentioned is that al-azm ala an la yu'ud, that the person is determined to not return to the sin that he or she committed. And then the final condition he mentioned, and he said that this is more serious than the other conditions, and he said, and that the tawbah is done during the time of repentance, meaning before the person is, you know, on their deathbed and that death is overtaking them. Or before Tawbah, the hour is established when Tawbah will not be accepted. So this shows us the importance of habatifillah, of these conditions, and that in order to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it should be done sincerely for His sake, not to please the people, not to become famous for your piety, but rather in order to please your Lord and leave off the ma'asi. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with ilman nafiya, rizqan tayyiba, wa amalan mutaqabbilan, wa tawba nasuha. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.